All right, here we are for game two. This hand looks pretty good. We have Cage, Brainstorm, etc. I guess I screwed up the recording a little bit there, but it doesn't matter. Turn one, death right. Well, let's see what he's got to start. So, oops, wrong thing. So he has a lot of ways to interact with Cage, it looks like. However, a little bit short in the mana department, which means I kind of want to just plow the death right now. It's too bad he has two ways to deal with. He has a way to deal with Ascendancy and Cage between his two Abrupt Decays. It's kind of annoying. Alright. Cradle was a good draw, to be sure. But now his hand is Decay, Decay, Glimpse. So I guess let's start with Ponder. Okay, Force of Will is definitely going to be good, so we're going to want to draw that. Questions if we want Fairy Conclave or Flooded Strand. I think we just want the Conclave. We're going to want both the lands anyway, so fine with just getting them now. We can use the Probe to draw the Force of Will. So we'll do that. Probe, see the cards we already know about. And pass. So we can Force of Will pitching Fatestitcher. When he tries to go for it with Glimpse. Looks like he's just going to cast whatever creature he drew anyway. Quarian Ranger, sure. So he can, yeah, he can leave his board all the way untapped, but that doesn't really change matters at all. So, he has two Abrupt Decays. So I guess we should start with a Brainstorm. Try and find alternate methods of winning. For example, Treasure Cruise is a pretty good card that we're going to be able to cast this turn, right? The Brainstorm's not actually in the yard, it's still on the stack. So we can put back the two Ascendancies, just cast Treasure Cruise, and then cast Grafdigger's Cage. And then we're actually going to have enough permanent-based cards to overpower his Abrupt Decays. So that's great. Let's see. We definitely want a Volcanic. Yeah, this looks good. And then next turn, we'd probably just play Young Pyromancer and plow his Symbiote, to be honest. We'll take a beatdown. But I don't think we're going to die to beatdowns. Probably. Yeah, it looks like we're not. I think he's probably going to cast Abrupt Decay here. No? Okay. Well, whatever. I guess he's going to try and kill us with damage, so it makes sense that he'll leave the cage around. Yeah, we might actually lose this game. Just to being attacked. Yeah, decaying our Pyromancer. So we can hit his Wirewood Symbiote, get a guy, he decays our guy and fours us. And then we're at two. How do we win from two? I have to draw like a Treasure Cruise or something. Man, that life loss adds up, doesn't it? Well, I don't see a better line. We can plow our own guy, and then he decays our guy and fives us, and we're at three. It's not that different. Yeah, it's pretty much the same. All right. Or is it the same? If we draw Probe, we can Probe, discard Fatestitcher, play a land. No, it is. It's the same. Okay. Yeah, we'll plow the symbiote. Get a guy. A little flooded on the Jeskai Ascendancies this game, unfortunately. There's also a chance he chooses to not kill the elemental just because it's kind of risky. Yeah, it looks like he is, or I don't think he would make this attack. I think he's going to attack with everybody and then decay the elemental in combat. Oh, no? Okay. Well, that's nice, at least. That probably buys us an extra turn to find another young pyromancer. Perfect. Is that perfect? Eh, it's not actually that good. I think we just don't play it, and we try and we block Nettle Sentinel with Fairy Conclave, and then next turn we can play the pyromancer, block Heritage Druid, or get it decayed, more likely. Like, if he goes decay your elemental, go for the win. We block Nettle Sentinel with Fairy Conclave, and then, yeah, I think that's our best line. Or try to find Electricery. Both, either one would be good. Oh, he gets a Dryad Arbor here. I forgot about that. Okay, this line is a lot worse then. Yeah, I forgot about Dryad Arbor. Shoot. I mean, he might be worried about Electricery also, so he might not go for it. But if he does, I don't think we can... Well, unless we draw exactly Electricery, I don't think we can win. And even if we do, he can pick it up with Quirion Ranger, pick up the Arbor, so it's pretty safe. Yeah, I think he just has to get Dryad Arbor here, actually. Wow, so he decided not to go get Dryad Arbor. That is both very surprising and probably very fortunate for us. And now he also needs a green spell to even untap his Nettle Sentinel. Okay, I guess you can do it that way too. That makes sense. Definitely blocking with Fairy Conclave if he attacks. Can't decay that one. So he drew a Dryad Arbor. Okay. So we play a Pyromancer, it gets decayed. The good thing about that is if he decays it now, then he doesn't get to get the other Dryad Arbor. So we get to continue to try and like trade with his guys, which might work out. Okay, he's too coy for that, but he still didn't go fetch the other Dryad Arbor, which is really interesting. I think he is still probably going to just decay the Pyromancer here. But then we can block Quirion Ranger, go to 2. Oh, no decay even. Huh. If we draw a spell, we're in really good shape. I mean, that was a good spell, too. He might be back on the, like, killing us with his combo plan, but we're gonna be able to go off here. We have a Grafdigger's Cage also. I guess we just fire this off now, or I can wait for him to fetch, maybe. I'll attack with my one elemental anyway. Yeah, I guess we can just Electricery on his end step, and that's just better. Unless he's very, very coy, which I don't think he will be. I don't think our opponent will realize that if he draws like Natural Order and wants to, he should actually go Abrupt Decay cast Natural Order and then Abrupt Decay the cage. But I don't think he would realize that. Anyway, he's Abrupt Decaying our Pyromancer, so it doesn't matter. We will Overload Electricity. Yeah, so he can't actually Natural Order here. So there's not that much scary stuff. He can't Green Sun either. Oh, that's why he wasn't fetching Dryad Arbors. Ooh, choke. That's annoying. Obviously, he wasn't fetching Dryad Arbors because of Grafdigger's Cage. I'm very stupid. Alright, Fairy Conclave helps get us out from choke. And we'll continue our very mediocre beatdown. If we can actually get a Fatestitcher into play, that also gets us out from choke, because we can slowly untap our lands. So we have that to strive for. Alright, he's going off a bit. I mean, not really going off, but just getting a bunch of guys in play, which is obviously bad for us. Yeah, I think we should just play this Young Pyromancer. Sucks to lose access to another land, but I think it's worth it. Treasure Cruise would be fantastic. Alright, so he's going all in. We definitely want to kill off his Visionaries, and I think we'd rather kill the Arbor than the Heritage Druid, because it's more likely he'll find a way to save that with like Aquarian Ranger or what have you. Ugh, he drew the other Arbor. Yeah, we're dead. Well, I was not really expecting choke, because most elf decks don't play it. I don't think it's very good, but it's probably like a budget option. And it is definitely good against us. So for sideboarding, now that we've seen more of what's going on, I don't think things really change for us. We have Force of Will to counter choke. We can Fatestitcher out through it, so it's not that scary. The Young Pyromancers were really good that game. Yeah, I'll just leave it like this.